Hello everyone, this is Payal Vaja. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will discuss about WHO guidelines on transfer of technology. So let's get started. These are the list of contents we will discuss in this video. First one is WHO guidelines on transfer of technology. Second one is scope of transfer of technology. Introduction. These guiding principles on transfer of technology are intended to serve as a framework which can be applied in a flexible manner rather than as a strict, rigid guidance. That means this guiding principle on transfer of technology, they are one type of framework which can be applied in flexible manner rather than strict, rigid manner. So, guidelines on transfer of technology, that is applied in a flexible manner rather than strict, rigid guidance. Focus has been placed on the quality aspects in line with WHO's mandate. So, what is the focus or concentration of WHO guidelines on transfer of technology? So, focus has been placed on quality aspects according to WHO guideline. So, quality is maintained during technology transfer. That is a mandatory. Transfer of process to an alternative site occurs at some stage in the life cycle of most product, from development, scale up, manufacturing, production and launch, and to the post approval phase. So, what is the transfer of process to alternative site that occur in various stages in the life cycle of most product, from the development, scale up, manufacturing, production and launch, and finally post approval phase. That is the life cycle of transfer of process. First step is products are prepared. Product in the development stage. During development stage, scale up is occur and manufacturing is side by side manufacturing is running. After manufacturing of any product, production of dosage form and launch the product. Four, post-approval phases. Transfer of technology is defined as, so first of all, what is transfer of technology? Transfer of technology is defined as a logical procedure that controls the transfer of any process together with its documentation and professional expertise between development and manufacture or between manufacture sites. So, first of all, what is transfer of technology? It is a one type of logical process that controls transfer of any process together with its documentation and professional expertise between development and manufacture as well as between manufacture site. So, transfer of technology, that is the logical process which control transfer of any process, that is together with its documentation and professional expertise between development and manufacture as well as between manufacturing site. It is a systematic procedure that is followed in order to pass the documented knowledge and experience gained during development and or commercialization to an appropriate, responsible and authorized party. So, transfer of technology, it is a one type of systematic procedure that is followed in order to pass the documented knowledge. So, it is a systematic procedure. So, it gives the knowledge regarding documentation preparation and experience is gained during development or commercialization to an appropriate, responsible and authorized party. So, transfer of technology, that is the systemic procedure and that is followed in order to pass or it gives the idea regarding documentation preparation and give the experience during development to an appropriate, responsible and authorized party. Technology transfer embodies both the transfer of documentation and demonstrated ability of receiving unit to effectively perform the critical elements of the transformed technology to the satisfaction of all the parties and any applicable regulatory bodies. So, technology transfer embodies both. First one is transfer of documentation and second one is demonstrate ability of receiving unit to effectively perform critical elements of transform technology. So, technology transfer embodies both body, transfer of documentation as well as receiving ability of receiving unit. Both are effectively perform the critical elements of transformed technology to the satisfaction of all parties and any applicable regulatory bodies or not. Literature searches revealed little information on the subject originating from national or regional regulatory bodies. So, literature survey or literature search that revealed that little information or any information on the subject that is originated from national or regional regulatory bodies. Guidance on intra-company transfer was prepared by International Society for Pharmaceutical Engineering. So, guidance, which type of guidance is provided? Guidance on intra-company transfer was prepared by International Society for Pharmaceutical Engineering. What is intra-company? Transfer from one company to another company, that is called as intra-company transfer. So, intra-company transfer was prepared by ISPE. The ever-changing business strategies of pharmaceutical companies, increasingly which involve intra and inter-company transfer of technology for a reasons. So, one type of changing business strategy. So, business strategies are changes nowadays. So, due to this reason, pharmaceutical companies increasingly involve intra and inter-company transfer of technology for many reasons, such as need for additional capacity, relocation of operations or consolidations and mergers. So, according to this time, changing business strategy of pharmaceutical company, that is increasing. So, it involves intra and intercompany transfer of technology for various reasons. Which type of reasons are available? So, need for additional capacity. Additional capacity is required. Otherwise, relocation of operations or consolidations and mergers. The WHO expert committee on specifications for pharmaceutical preparations, therefore, recommended in its 42nd report that WHO address this issue through preparation of WHO guidelines on this matter. So, WHO expert committee, what is the function of WHO expert committee? World Health Organization expert committee on specification for pharmaceutical preparation. So, WHO expert have a specification on pharmaceutical preparation. Therefore, they recommended in its 42nd report that WHO address any type of issue is occur or not through the preparation of WHO guidelines on this type of matters. Transfer of technology requires a documented planned approach using trained and knowledgeable person working within a quality system. With documentation of data covering all aspects of development, production and quality control. So, transfer of technology which requires documentation, planned approach using trained and knowledgeable person, they are working within a quality system. And with documentation of data which cover all the aspects of development, production and quality control. So, transfer of technology require, first one is it require documentation, second one is planned approach are used. Why? Planned approach using trained and knowledgeable person. They are working within a quality system. So, plan approach is prepared. So, in plan approach, trained and knowledgeable person are working and they are working with quality system and maintain the quality by trained and knowledgeable person. With documentation of trained and knowledgeable person working by maintaining the quality as well as they provide documentation of data covering all the aspects of development, production and quality control. Usually, there is a sending unit or receiving unit and the unit managing the process which may or may not be separate entity. So, there is a sending unit and receiving unit and unit managing process, both are managing process. Sending unit and receiving unit, both are unit managing process which may or may not be separated. Sending unit sends some data while receiving unit receives some data. So, which may or may not be separated. For contract manufacturing, please see good manufacturing practice. So, for contract manufacturing. Purpose: follow the guidelines according to good manufacturing practice. For the transfer to be successful, the following general principles and requirements should be met. So, for the successful transformation, following principles are following principles meet with some requirement. The project plan should encompass the quality aspects of the project and be based upon the principle of quality risk management. So any type of project plan that is prepared, it should be encompass the quality aspect. So project plan that is encompass or maintain quality aspect of project, as well as based upon principle of quality risk management. What is quality risk management? We will discuss in next lecture. The capability of sending unit and at the receiving unit should be similar, but not necessarily identical, and facilities and equipment should operate according to similar operating principle. So, capability of sending unit as well as receiving unit should be almost similar, but they are not necessarily identical, and facilities and equipment should operate according to similar principle. So, capacity of sending unit and receiving unit both are same or almost similar, but they are not necessary to identical, facilitate and equipment are operated according to similar principle. A comprehensive technical gap analysis between sending unit and receiving unit, including technical risk assessment and potential regulatory gaps, should be performed as needed. So, a comprehensive, any type of technical gap analysis occur between sending unit and receiving unit. So, they include technical risk assessment and potential regulatory gaps should be performed as required. Adequately trained staff should be available or should be trained at the receiving unit. So adequately trained staff or experienced staff should be available or should be trained at receiving unit. So in some cases trained staff is available at receiving unit, while some cases trained staff should be trained at receiving unit. So first one is regulatory requirements in the countries of sending unit and receiving unit, and in any countries where the product is intended to be supplied, should be taken into account and interpreted consistently throughout any transfer program project. So, regulatory requirements in countries of sending unit as well as receiving unit, and in any country where product is intended to be supplied, it should be taken into account as well as interpreted consistently throughout any transfer program project. So regulatory requirement in country of sending unit as well as receiving unit, and in any country where product is supplied, they should be taken into account and it should be interpreted consistently throughout technology transfer program project. And there should be effective process and product knowledge transfer. So this type of process, it should be effective and product knowledge transfer. Technology transfer can be considered successful if there is documented evidence that the receiving unit can routinely reproduce the transferred product, process, or method against a predefined set of specifications as agreed with sending unit. So, technology transfer can be considered as successful. Why technology transfer can be considered as successful? If there is a documented evidence is available that the receiving unit can routinely reproduce transfer product, process, or any method against predefined set of specification agreed with sending unit. When technology transfer can be considered as a successful? If there is a documented evidence is available that the receiving unit, so documented evidence said that the receiving unit can routinely reproduce the transfer product, process, or any method against predefined set of specification that is agreed with sending unit. So in this case, technology transfer can be considered as successful. In the event that the receiving unit identifies particular problems with the process during the transfer, the receiving unit should communicate them back to the sending unit to ensure continuing knowledge management. So in the event that receiving unit, what is the function of receiving unit? So receiving unit identify particular problem or particular matter with the process during transfer. So during transfer of technology, any type of problem is occur. So it should be identified by receiving unit, and receiving unit should communicate them back to sending unit. After identification of problem, receiving unit communicate with sending unit to ensure continuing knowledge management. Technology transfer project, particularly those between different companies, have a legal and economic implications. So technology transfer project, particularly between different companies, that have a legal and economical implications. If such issues, which may include intellectual property rights, royalties, pricing, or conflict of interest and confidentially are expected to impact on open communication of technical matter in any way, they should be addressed before and during planning and execution of the transfer. So first one is technology transfer project between the different companies that have a legal and economic implications. If such issues, which may include, which type of issues may include intellectual property rights, any type of royalties, pricing, conflict of interest, and confidentially, they are expected to impact on open communication. Effect or impact on open communication of technical matters in any way. So if any type of issue is occur, so this type of issue are communicated, openly communicated, and they should be addressed before and during planning and execution of the transfer. Any lack of transparency may lead to ineffective transfer of technology. So, any lack of transparency which may lead to ineffective transfer of technology. So, if any lack or any miss of transparency which may lead to not a proper or not a that much effective transfer of technology. Some of the principles outlined in this document may also be applicable to manufacturing investigational pharmaceutical products for clinical trials as a part of research and development. But this is not the main focus of this guidance and has been excluded due to the complexity of processes. So in this case, some of the principles that are outlined in these documents, which may also be applicable to manufacturing investigational pharmaceutical product for clinical trial as a part of research and development. So, some principles are outlined or mentioned in document. They may be applicable to manufacturing investigational pharmaceutical product for clinical trial that are act as a part of research and development. But this is not the main focus of this guidance and has been excluded due to the complexity of process. So that is not a main focus of guideline. So due to that reason, that is excluded due to complexity of process. What is the scope of technology transfer according to WHO guidelines? Note that this section specially provides for transfer of quality control method where a technical agreement exists, sending unit manufacturer to receiving unit manufacturer or sending unit manufacturer to receiving unit quality control laboratory. So in scope, this section provides for transfer of quality control method where technical agreements are available for transfer of quality control. First one is, which type of technical agreements are existed? Sending unit manufacturer to receiving unit manufacturer. Otherwise, sending unit manufacturer to receiving unit quality control laboratory. Technology transfer is occur via this way, where no such technical agreements exist. Example, testing by national laboratories or testing for procurement agencies. So any technical agreements are not exist, in which case testing by national laboratories or testing for procurement agencies. During this case, technical agreements are present require. A number of points listed in section 2.4 may not be workable and alternative approach may be required. So, this type of point, number of points, they are listed in section 4, that is the above section. They may not be workable and alternative approach that is required. Note is section number 2.4. This document gives a guidance in principle and provides general recommendations on the activities necessary to conduct a successful intra or inter-site transfer of technology as described in the introduction to these guidelines. So, this document which gives a guidance in principle and which provide general recommendation regarding activities they are necessary to conduct a successful intra or inter-site transfer of technology. So, this type of document provides the guidance regarding principle and it provides general recommendation on activities they are necessary to conduct a successful intra as well as inter-site transfer of technology that is already described in introduction to these guidelines. The intention is to address the basic considerations needed for a successful transfer in order to satisfy the regulatory authority defined for the transfer process. What is the intention of this guideline? The intention is to address the basic consideration that is required for a successful transfer in order to satisfy regulatory authority defined for transfer process. So, what is the main intention or main purpose of this guideline? Main purpose of guideline is successful transfer of technology transfer. Due to that reason, satisfy the regulatory authority by successful transfer of process. The guidelines will be applied to manufacturing active pharmaceutical ingredients, manufacturing and packaging of bulk materials, manufacturing and packaging of finished pharmaceutical products, and performing analytical testing. So, WHO guideline for technology transfer that is applied to manufacturing of active pharmaceutical excipient as well as that is applied on manufacturing and packaging of bulk materials, manufacturing and packaging of finished pharmaceutical product, and last one is that is applied on performing analytical testing. The recommendations provided in these guidelines apply to all dosage form but need to be adjusted on a case-by-case basis. Example, by using risk management principles. So, recommendations that is provided in WHO guidelines that is applicable to all the dosage form but that require some adjustment on case-by-case. So, recommendation is provided in this guideline. This is applied to all dosage form. But this guidelines is some type of adjustment is required in this guideline due to case by case changes. Particularly, close control of certain aspects will be required for certain formulations such as sterile product, and metered dose aerosols. So some type of close control aspects will be required, particularly for which type of formulation, like any sterile product. Quality control is maintained, sterility is maintained, metered dose aerosol. In both cases, close control is maintained. WHO guidance on manufacture of specific pharmaceutical products will be useful in this regard. So, WHO guideline on the manufacture of specific pharmaceutical products. What is specific pharmaceutical products? That is sterile products, metered dose aerosol, etc. That will be useful in this regard. These guidelines address the following areas at sending unit as well as receiving unit. So this guideline following various areas at sending unit as well as receiving unit. First one is transfer of development and production. In bracket, processing, packaging and cleaning is required. So transfer of R&D, research and development to the production area. Processing, packaging and cleaning step is required. Second one is transfer of analytical methods for quality assurance and quality control. So product should be transferred from analytical analysis or quality analysis for quality assurance as well as quality control. Next one is skill assessment and training. So any person, they are working with technology transfer, they skill assessment, they have a skill is required and they are trained properly. Organization and management of transfer is required and assessment of premises and equipment. Because each transfer project is unique and the provision of a comprehensive set of guidelines is beyond the scope of this document. Because each project or each transfer project is unique or different. Due to that reason, provision of comprehensive set of guidelines, it should be beyond the scope of documents. These guidelines do not provide guidance on any legal, financial or commercial considerations associated with technology transfer projects. So this WHO guideline on technology transfer, they do not provide any guidance regarding any legal, any financial or commercial consideration they are associated with technology transfer project. Documentation and last one is qualification and validation. We will discuss in next lectures. Thank you.